Let me give you a look at the statement, Lindsay. This is from Shane Smith and Suroosh Alvi. They are the co-founders of Vice. And this is a statement that they sent out to their employees. So take a look at what they say. Listening to our employees over the past year, the truth is inescapable. From the top down, we have failed as a company to create a safe and inclusive workplace where everyone, especially women, and the statement goes on to say, can feel respected and thrive. Cultural elements from our past, dysfunction and mismanagement were allowed to flourish unchecked. That includes a detrimental, quote, boys club culture that fostered inappropriate behavior. It happened on our watch, and ultimately we let far too many people down. We are truly sorry for this. That is a mea culpa that you can see there, but what's not sure is exactly how and what this will mean in terms of the actual allegations and what kind of responsibility they're going to take.
A fulsome sort of statement, but what do we know about the kinds of allegations that are prompting it?
Okay, so what we know, at least from the New York Times, that we've got four settlements involving allegations of sexual harassment or defamation against Vice employees, including its current president. This is Andrew Creighton. To give you an example with that particular person, allegedly, this was in 2016, $135,000 was paid to a former employee who claimed that Creighton was rejected, after she rejected an intimate relationship with him, that she was fired. And so, like I say, this is a settlement that involved $135,000. What you're looking at right here, Lindsay, this is a scroll of the Vice website and all of their stories of sexual allegations against other people. And they've been very active about those stories, as they are with a lot of these heavy-hitting stories. They've always, you know, boasted about being very much on the cutting edge. And this is an organization that has gone from a magazine that was out of Montreal and now, you know, a $6 billion multimedia kind of company. So that's the scale and the scope that we're talking about. And according to the New York Times, on top of those the settlements that I just mentioned, more than two dozen other women, mostly in their 20s and 30s, they said that they had experienced or witnessed sexual misconduct at the company. So everything from unwanted kisses, groping, touching, lewd remarks, and propositions for sex. So this is something that really stands out, Lindsay, because a lot of the harassment allegations we've been talking about, they involve older men, in the 60s, 70s, 80s. They keep referring to this older era of a different time. But with Vice, these are men in their 20s and 30s and 40s. And they certainly came of age at a time where it's not just that, you know, sexual harassment was taboo. It was against the law. So that's very interesting when you look at the context, you know?